Hello everybody, I've been asked by my YouTube friend MissMag822 to come up with a response video to his mathematical card trick. So I guess you'll need to watch that first, so if you haven't, click this link here and I'll put a link in the description as well. Okay, the card trick he described had two parts. First of all, you picked three cards and you placed them into the pack. And then the second part was the reveal. I'm going to do the second part first. So what I've got here is 52 cards, 52 shuffled cards, as you can see. And what I've done is I've labelled these cards 1 to 52. So from top to bottom, labelled them from 1 to 52. And what we're going to do is to make two piles, a face-up pile and a face-down pile. So let's do that. So it's face-up, face-down, face-up, face-down, and so on, all the way through the pack. I hope you appreciate that I've ruined a perfectly decent pack of cards by doing this. That's 99p I'll never get back. So up and down, all the way through the pack. It's harder than it looks, this. Up and down. And there we have it. Right, now what we're going to do is get rid of the face up pile, so that's gone. Okay, we're left with these cards, and the effect of doing this is twofold. Firstly, we've removed all the cards in the odd places. Secondly, we've reversed the order of the remaining cards, the cards that were in the even places. So let's do this again. Just like before, up, down, up, down. Now the effect is the same. We're removing the cards, the face-up cards, from the odd-numbered places, and the remaining cards are put into reverse order. So I get rid of the face-up cards. I'm going to do this two more times. So it's up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. It's important to start with the card face-up first. Okay, get rid of the face-up cards. And one more time. Up, down. Okay, get rid of those cards. We're left with three cards. These three cards are the card in the 6th place, the card in the 22nd place, and the card that was originally in the 38th place. And these three cards are your chosen cards. And these cards will always be the cards that are left behind. Now, all we have to do is find a way to put our chosen cards into those positions. So the setup that MissMag822 described, I'm going to do for you now. I may put another alternative in the description. But this is what he did. First of all, he puts his first chosen card on this pile. By the way, these are four piles. This is a pile of 10 cards. This is a pile of 15 cards. This is another pile of 15 cards. And finally, this is the remaining 9 cards. So, like I said, he put his first chosen card on this pile. Then he could cut the pack next to it anywhere he wanted to and put it on top. So let's do that. He then put his second chosen card on top of this pile. And he was allowed to cut the pack next to it anywhere he wanted to and put it on top. Finally, he put his remaining card on top of this last pile, and that's what he had. Now, if we start to gather up these piles, this is what happens. If I put this pile on top, all I've done here is these two chosen cards are 15 cards apart. No matter where I cut the pack, these two chosen cards will always be 15 cards apart. Same when I put this pack on top. These two chosen cards are 15 cards apart, doesn't matter where I cut the pack. And finally, I'm going to put these 9 cards on top. So if I gather these cards up, the first chosen card is here. It's the 10th card from the top. Well, that's not where I want it to be. So let's take 4 cards off the top, put them on the bottom, and now all my chosen cards are exactly where I want them to be. This is the 6th card from the top. 15 cards later, we'll find the 22nd card, and 15 cards after that, we'll find the 38th card. The chosen cards are exactly where I want them to be. If I do this up-down part, we will get our remaining chosen cards. And that's how you do it. So if you're happy, thanks for watching.